shattered slate they cautiously walked, greeted by cawing ravens and the black cat that stalked. Clang, 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 the cauldron-shaped door knocker rang. Creak, 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 the giant oak doors slowly swang. Standing before them was the cutest child, almost their age. With a wink and a wave, he invited them into his magnificent Victorian cage. To his parlor they followed, where an enormous mound of sweet treats they did greet.
Where did you get all this candy?
The children dared to ask.
I took it from the good townspeople. 'Twas quite a task. Here, why don't you have some?
He offered, presenting a tattered old sack. Several pieces they took, smelled, and tasted. But moments later, they began to gag and hack. The children cried.
It tastes like shoe leather and slugs mixed into a stale dough.
I'm not surprised, the boy said, as I stole it nearly a century ago or so.
The children's mouths agape, they did fear. What is this boy thing standing far, far too near? And for the first time, he did smile, exposing teeth yellow, pointed, and vile.
You, and with those bites, you now share my plight. To live in this mansion for eternal night.
The thick doors groaned loudly and slowly began to shut.
Uh-oh.
The children raced for their freedom, faster than any hunter's hungry mutt. What of their fate? Did they escape? No one knows, but have